Great. So good morning, everyone. For those of you who might have been going through the brochure, you would have figured out by now that I'm not Maya Hari. So Maya couldn't make it. So that's why I'm here today. As I just mentioned, so I take care of strategic accounts for Twitter in India, been with them for about a year now. And I'm going to talk about the future of mobile retailing as we see it, because Twitter is predominantly a mobile platform. We're also about winning the moment, because it's the most real-time platform that we possibly have in the world today. So that's what my keynote is going to be about. So let's not dither further and get right into it. As with everything at Twitter, we like to have a hashtag to things. I guess it's already being followed since yesterday, so please keep continuing with that. That's my handle if you want to keep up to date with what's new and noteworthy at Twitter. Great. Quick show of hands. How many of you have played Clash of Clans? Don't think about how it's relevant. Just one, that's it. Two, three, okay, a few people. For those you haven't, take a look at this. Love this video, and I'm guessing a lot of other people across the world loved it too. This aired during the Super Bowl this year as a TV commercial, and this is what happened. Right? So what you're seeing right now on the screen is the volume of tweet impressions as the commercial was aired on prime time during the Super Bowl. Right? That's at its peak, it was about 6.5 million impressions, and it's not just the quantity we're talking about here, right? If you look at some of the tweets which people spoke about, some real gems here. Somebody talking about how Liam convinced them to download Clash of Clans. Another guy who actually built a wall to defend himself against a level 3, against Liam Neeson in the game, right? What all of these essentially indicate is the level of engagement that people have with games, and that too by just seeing a TVC around it, right? And it's not just games that we're talking about here. This is a heat map, and you might not see most of the world, but it's basically a map of the world in the background with a heat map of tweets coming out across different parts of the world. Essentially, all the part that's black is the boring part of the world, which is a lot of Russia, China, parts of Australia, which nobody lives there, etc. But the idea is that this conversation happening every day around things that are that important to users, right? Whether it's games, whether it's mobile apps, right? And being a retail conference, I'm guessing every retailer out there worth its weight has an app, right? Or some sort of an app or some sort of a mobile engagement platform. So what I'm essentially trying to say is that the future of retail is mobile. And consumers are engaging with your apps, with your content, with your commercials, not just every day, but billions of times in a day, right? So what we're seeing is that you have these insane volume of moments that matter. And when I say billions, these moments are occurring at that scale, right? Now, just to give you some perspective at how human connection takes place on Twitter. Before I get into this, again, a quick show of hands, how many of you are not on Twitter? I don't want to see you in this hall. Please, you can leave. Just kidding. So the idea is that we have 77 million users in India, and it's growing. India's the largest, fastest growing market for Twitter now across the world. So if you're not on Twitter, you really are missing out on a lot.
I got this
and
call
if you don't
from
believe me,
saying,
listen to
I've
Patrick Stewart.
I've just seen this tweet. You must look at this right away.
The whole narrative of life, whether it's about events, whether it's about your favorite piece of a dress hanging in a shop window somewhere, or whether you're browsing through the latest sale on Myntra or Flipkart or ordering something from a Tiny Owl, etc., right? It's immaterial. If there's something that matters to you, chances are it matters to a lot of other people as well, and that forms the connection between you and the world. All those conversations are happening at scale, day in and day out, right? And this forms the largest searchable collection of human thought that has ever existed, right? And we're talking billions and billions of moments, right? So it took us 5 years to get to 1 billion tweets. Now we do that every 2 days. But these are not just things that people are talking about, whether they're shopping, etc. Each tweet is a signal of intent, right? And it's true for pretty much every other digital platform out there. So while I'm just focusing on Twitter because they pay my salary, but yeah, it's true for every digital piece, whether it's a WhatsApp, whether it's a Facebook, whether it's a YouTube, etc. Because every digital content gives you multiple data points. Who's created it? Who's consuming it? What time of the day? Where did it come from? What's the context? Who all responded to it? Is there a brand mention? How many brands responded back to it? What else has this user talked about? Where was he when he did this? What else has he been doing in the last 1 week? And so on and so forth. When you start analyzing those data points, you realize there are patterns and trends. And as retailers, as marketeers, it's those patterns and trends which give you actionable insights on how to reach out to your target audience. So we're in the midst of a major shift, and this is possibly the most popular slides from Mary Meeker's presentation about 2 years back. So Pope's inauguration 2005, 2013, dramatic shift in how users consume and share content with the world. And I'm just going to skip through in the interest of time. So what's basically happening is that we've seen an average consumer unlocks their phone 110 times a day. So this number came out a year back. Last night, I was at a trend briefing from Trend Watching. They're doing the first event in India and Delhi. And they said that the updated number is 221. So it's already doubled in a year, right? And this is not for receiving or making calls, right? This is, you don't need to unlock your phone for receiving a call, right? So these are the number of opportunities in a day when you can reach out to a user on their mobile phone and deliver an engagement. Great. Massive volume of research, purchase research happened on the smartphone, right? Simply because people are on the go. You mentioned showrooming was a major discussion yesterday. It's impacting retailers, not just in India, but across the world. We also see that a significant portion, 60% of retail purchases, happen by regular Twitter users. That's the scale we're looking at, right? Now, all of these are coming together to create massive retail opportunities. Right? Now, 1 billion tweets, put together by about 302 million monthly active users, out of which almost 230 million are mobile users, which is 76%. India is 80, so it's ahead of the curve in that sense. And about 200 million monthly shoppers, right? These are brand engagers. In fact, slightly digressing, but 60% of people who join Twitter join it to follow a brand. So that's the opportunity that exists to reach out to users there. Right. Again, you repeated the stat. This is more interesting. So you can reach out to them first thing in the day, just when they wake up, or when they're traveling to work, traveling back from work, or when they are at work, right? We see that desktop usage usually goes up when people are at work, but that doesn't mean that mobile goes down. It still remains pretty significant. And people are likely to use it while shopping. So if you're an offline retailer who has an online app, you want to drive conversion, that's your cue. If you are an online retailer who doesn't have an offline presence, that's your cue in terms of how to get the integration going. Great. All of this has happened, again, I don't need to possibly tell you, is because of this one device which is usually at less than a feet's distance from you, which is the mobile phone. 600% increase in mobile growth in the last, this is dated obviously 2013, so the numbers are just going to be much higher if we're looking at it today. So all this brings us to just one sort of boiling point, which is brands no longer have target markets, right? So yesterday's discussion, interestingly, was also on a similar topic, which is post-demographic consumerism. So what we were speaking about was that the classic norms of reaching out to users based on demographics do not exist any longer, simply because of a tribe mentality have come in. So you have niches, whether large or small, and as a retailer or brand, you need to address those. Hence, you don't just have target markets, but the way we like to call it is that as a brand, you have target moments. And these are the moments which decide whether you win the consumer or not, right? So these are the billion of moments on every 2 days that I'm talking about. Now, what we provide as a platform is greater connection in the moment, right? Simply because, A, we're public, so it's completely searchable. It's the only digital platform which you can search through. It's real time, so it's live, right? It's conversational, so it's not